countered with use of lethal weapons and disproportionate use of force by the Indian occupation forces. Their mass participation in the funerals of the martyrs is a clear manifestation of their defiance, as well as their determination to free themselves. Indeed, in the history of past 70 years, it has been demonstrated time and again that the ferocity and inhumanity of India's state terrorism and IOK is no match to the resolve and resilience of the innocent, unarmed Kashmiri people. India will never be able to break their will, nor will it succeed in misleading the world community through its malicious propaganda campaign, painting the just, legitimate, and indigenous Kashmiri struggle for realization of the right to self-determination as quote-unquote terrorism. Pakistan remains in full solidarity with the people of Jammu and Kashmir. Pakistan also welcomes the strong support demonstrated by the OIC member states for the resolution of the Jammu and Kashmir dispute in line with the UN Security Council resolutions and the wishes of the Kashmiri people at the 45th session of the OIC Council of Foreign Ministers held in Dhaka on 5th-6th May. We urge the international community to take cognizance of the brutal repression and massive violations of human rights taking place in IOK and to use its influence with India to bring an immediate end to the culture of impunity that has been fostered there for 7 decades. Pakistan also calls upon the world community to play its rightful role in promoting a just and lasting solution of the Jammu and Kashmir dispute in accordance with the UN Security Council resolutions and the wishes of the Kashmiri people. We believe this is a sine qua non for durable peace and stability in South Asia. Prime Minister Shahid Khaqan Abbasi has condemned the escalation of systematic brutalities, killing of innocent civilians, and human rights violations committed by the Indian occupation forces with impunity in Indian-occupied Jammu and Kashmir. The 45th session of the OIC Council of Foreign Ministers concluded in Dhaka on 6th of May. The Pakistani delegation was led by Foreign Secretary Tehmina Janjua. One of the main highlights of the session was the strong support demonstrated by the OIC member states to the just cause of the Kashmiri people through the unanimous adoption of multiple resolutions and endorsement of the report of the recently held emergency session of the OIC contact group on Jammu and Kashmir in Jeddah. Both the resolutions and the report of the contact group reaffirm OIC's support for the realization of the right of the Kashmiri people to self-determination in accordance with the UN Security Council resolutions. The contact group report drew attention towards the rise in gross and systematic human rights violations in the Indian-occupied Jammu and Kashmir, terming them as crimes against humanity. The OIC position clearly is manifested by the 5 resolutions on Jammu and Kashmir dispute, which were unanimously adopted on 6th May during the 45th CFM by all member states. These resolutions reaffirmed Kashmiri people's right to self-determination in accordance with UNSC resolutions and condemned India for human rights violations in IOK. These 5 resolutions are Resolution number 8/45 on the Jammu and Kashmir dispute. Resolution number 9/45 on the peace process between India and Pakistan. Resolution number 3/45C on protection of Islamic holy places. Destruction of Babri Masjid in India and protection of Islamic holy places. Destruction of Charare Sharif Islamic complex in Kashmir and other Islamic sites therein. Resolution on matters pertaining to the work of the OIC Independent Permanent Human Rights Commission. Resolution on economic assistance to OIC member states and Muslim communities in disputed/occupied territories and non-OIC countries within the OIC mandate. On the sidelines of the conference, the Foreign Secretary met OIC Secretary General, Foreign Ministers of Saudi Arabia, Senegal, Minister of State of Uganda, and her counterparts from Morocco, Malaysia, Tunis, Indonesia, heads of delegations of several other OIC countries. Separately, Pakistan strongly condemns the terrorist attack at voter registration center in a mosque in Khost, Afghanistan, killing and injuring scores of innocent people on 6th May, and the senseless and heinous terrorist attacks in Kabul yesterday. We are distressed and grieved at the loss of precious human lives. Such blatant terrorism, targeting innocent civilians and disrupting way of life, has no justification whatsoever. We express our deepest sympathies and heartfelt condolences to the families and friends of those who have lost their lives, and pray to Almighty Allah for early recovery of the injured. We express our support and solidarity with the people and government of Afghanistan in this hour of grief. A two-day international seminar on the present and future strategic export controls, organized by the Strategic Export Controls Division, Ministry of Foreign Affairs, began yesterday. The seminar is aimed at reinforcing networking among export control community and strengthening engagements for promoting regional and international cooperation against the proliferation of weapons of mass destruction and their delivery systems. The independent experts and representatives from different regions and countries, including from the states which are members of the Nuclear Suppliers Group, NSG, International Export Control Regimes, UNSC R 1540 Committee, academia and industry are taking part in the seminar. Lastly, Pakistan believes that the Joint Comprehensive Plan of Action, JCPOA, represents a very good example of a negotiated settlement of complex issues through dialogue and diplomacy. We had welcomed the JCPOA when it was concluded and hope that all the parties will find a way for its continuation, especially when the International Atomic Energy Agency has repeatedly verified Iran's compliance. We have noted the willingness of the parties to the agreement to work together on upholding their respective commitments as stipulated in the JCPOA, despite US decision to withdraw from it. Pakistan believes that international treaties and agreements concluded through painstaking negotiations are sacrosanct. Arbitrarily rescinding such agreements will undermine confidence in the value of dialogue and diplomacy in the conduct of international relations. Thank you very much. I'll take the questions. Janab, Mohsin sir.
Thank you, Dr. Faisal sir. I am Syed Mohsin Reza, representing SAS Group of Publications. Sir, the reference is Khalid Omar Khurasani. Mm-hmm. Pakistan is a respectable member of United Nations and a signatory to so many conventions over there. But when it comes to having a level playing field regarding Pakistan's diplomatic treatment, the UNSC rejected Pakistan's move. What other options are left? The question is for Pakistan to table that move once again, either on a UNSC forum or somewhere else. And what are the chances to get back that terrorist?
Ji, isi silsile mein ji. Alayda. We had welcomed the JCPOA when it was concluded and hope that all the parties will find a way for its continuation, especially when the International Atomic Energy Agency has repeatedly verified Iran's compliance. We have noted the willingness of the parties to the agreement to work together on upholding their respective commitments as stipulated in the JCPOA, despite US decision to withdraw from it. Pakistan believes that international treaties and agreements concluded through painstaking negotiations are sacrosanct. Arbitrarily rescinding such agreements will undermine confidence in the value of dialogue and diplomacy in the conduct of international relations. Thank you very much. I'll take the questions. Janab, Mohsin sir.
Thank you, Dr. Faisal sir. I am Syed Mohsin Raza representing Asas Group of Publications. Sir, the reference is Khalid Umar Khurasani. Pakistan is a respectable member of United Nations and a signatory to so many.